ना कि वी हैव गॉन ऑनलाइन.
नो ही इज गो ही विल गो ऑन एट 5.
ओके
देयर
फाइन,
इज
सो आई
नो
जस्ट लेट
इंडिकेशन
बी
एज
फाइव
सच.
एंड
ओके
ओके फाइन मैम. या
विनय, विल यू गिव कंफर्मेशन?
Good evening to everyone present here. In commemoration of Mahatma Education Society's Golden Jubilee year, Pillai HOC College of Architecture is pleased to organize this webinar on health and nutrition. Due to the current situation we all are facing, staying at home because of the lockdown has resulted in negligence of our health. But during the pandemic, staying healthy is of the most importance. To help us understand the importance of maintaining our health, we have our esteemed speaker present today. We are pleased to welcome Dr. Priyanka Joshi, PhD in Food Science and Nutrition from PGTD of Home Science, Nagpur University. And she is the founder of 360 Degree Nutrition, which is a platform for improving and maintaining nutritional status. She has assessed the nutritional status and physical fitness of gymnasts and assessed 400 gymnasts aged 10 to 15 years on the basis of anthropometry and nutritional status. She is a renowned consultant who has provided consultation to clients from 10 different countries, including patients with diabetes, hypertension, cholesterol, etc. She has also undertaken curation and development of medical app named Case Mentor. We are honored to have you here with us today, ma'am. Kindly share your valuable knowledge with everyone who is present here.
Thank you for the kind introduction. I would also like to thank management of Pillai College for inviting me to present my views on health and nutrition in today's webinar. I am really honored to be here today with you all. So in the childhood itself, we come to know about the importance of diet and nutrition. And it is, excuse me, it is said that food is the basic necessity of our life. But is the food only necessary for the survival, or we should consider it as a remedy or a therapy or therapeutic ingredient in the recovery of any diseased condition? With every bite we are eating or feeding, either we are feeding our body or fighting with the diseases. In today's pandemic as well, it is highlighted that the person who has strong immunity will suffer less from the adverse effects of coronavirus infection than the person whose immunity is weak. So in the treatment of COVID cases also, the introduction of some vitamin supplements like vitamin C and zinc is regularly recommended or prescribed by a doctor. That again highlights the importance of health and nutrition. So in today's webinar, I will be covering and following topics. First of all, I would like to focus on some important health parameters which we should monitor on a regular basis. I will talk about balanced diet, food groups, will introduce. Also, there are a few factors which affects our immunity adversely. So we will discuss these factors also. At the same time, immunity boosting foods and nutrition nutrients we will be talking about. And there are a few health or dietary challenges which people are facing during the lockdown. So I will be happy to throw a light on these challenges and to discuss the ways to overcome these challenges. And finally, we'll share some diet tips for our students. So let us begin with the important health parameters. Today, the trend of annual checkup is on rise. That is definitely a good sign. But as per my experience, or I would like to suggest you to monitor your health on a regular basis. So on which factors or which parameters you should monitor at home, we will discuss in this slide. So start with daily activities. at the time when you wake up in the morning, you should feel fresh and calm. You should ready to accept the day's challenges in the morning itself. If you are feeling tired and lethargic throughout the day or in the morning hours, then there is a need to check your diet and modify your lifestyle. Secondly, most of us check our body weights and BMI on a regular basis. But additionally, I would like to suggest you to check your body composition regularly. You can check your body composition once in 2 months. So what is body composition? Body composition analysis tells you about the body fat percentage and muscle mass present in your body. Also, it is important to monitor your waist to hip ratio as well. Measure your waist, measure your hips, and take a ratio of it. It is a factor which decides or which indicates us whether we are at a risk of developing some metabolic disorders like diabetes or hypertension or heart-related issues. Ideal waist to hip ratio for adult male should be below 0.9, and for women it should be below 0.85. So along with body weight, check your body composition and waist to hip ratio as well. Then checking your hunger pattern and urination is also equally important. If you are following a regular routine, your meal timings are set, you are eating a proper controlled portions of healthy foods throughout the day on a regular basis, your bedtime is set, your waking up time is set, then there will not be any change in the frequency of your hunger or urination or any bowel movement. But if you notice a drastic change in your hunger pattern, like if you are feeling too hungry soon, like frequently you want to consume something which is so high in sugar or which is junk, or the frequency of urination has increased drastically, the color of urination has changed, you are not getting a clear motion in the morning, then it is a time to assess yourself thoroughly. Many of us crave for sweets, particularly after meals, or crave for junk food. That is also an indicator that your meals are not balanced. You may have some nutritional deficiencies, or you are following some irregular dietary pattern. For all these, after monitoring all these parameters, set your nutritional goal with the help of a nutritionist and start following a balanced diet. So what is balanced diet? A diet which is a balanced diet is a wholesome diet which provides all the essential nutrients in required amount from all the food groups. Also, it should supply all the macronutrients. Macronutrients are carbohydrates, proteins and fats, and micronutrients like vitamins and minerals for growth, maintenance of health, and proper regulation of metabolic processes. A diet should be customized to each and every person. Our diet will be balanced only if it is planned as per your age, your height, your activity levels, and your medical condition if you have any. So in short, we can say a balanced diet is a key in maintenance of our health. So what foods we should incorporate in your diet to make it a balanced diet? There are a few food groups designed by various institutions depending on the nutrient content in that particular food. Today we will be discussing food groups designed by ICMR, that is Indian Council of Medical Research. So basically, ICMR has grouped foods into 5 different types. The first is cereals, grains and products, which includes wheat, rice, jowar, bajra, oats, ragi, poha, kurkura and so on. The basic nutrient present in cereals and grain products is complex carbohydrates. Complex carbohydrates will provide you energy. 1 gram of carbohydrate gives you 4 kilocalories of energy. Other nutrients present in cereals, grains, and grains are proteins, invisible fat, some B complex vitamins like thiamine, folic acid, and riboflavin, iron, and fiber. You all know that when we eat something, when we eat some food, it gets converted to glucose. So the process of conversion of food to glucose requires B complex vitamins. So it is important to include cereals and grains also to get a daily dose of your vitamin B complex. Second group is pulses and legumes. This group includes various dals, right, like red gram dal, green gram, Bengal gram, and legumes like lentils or cowpeas, rajma, soybean, chickpeas, and so on. Most important feature or the nutrient you can say provided by these foods is protein. So we can call it a protein-rich group. But the quality of proteins present in pulses and legumes is not considered as complete protein. To get complete protein, you need to combine pulses with cereals. For example, when you eat khichdi, it becomes a complete food because it is a combination of rice and dal. Similarly, other combination of cereals and pulses foods are idli, dosa, and in Maharashtrians we prepare bhajni, thali pithachi bhajni. That is also considered as a complete protein because it is a combination of pulses and legumes. So this is important point for vegetarians. Then other nutrients which are present in pulses and legumes are energy, invisible fat, thiamine, folic acid, that is B complex vitamins, calcium, iron, and fiber. The third important food group is milk and milk products. As the name suggests, it contains milk and other milk products like curd, paneer, cheese, meats like chicken, meat, eggs, fish, etc. This particular food group provides protein which is complete in nature. So these are considered as high biological proteins or which gives us all the amino acids required in our body. So try to incorporate at least a milk product daily, and meat if you are non-vegetarian, try to add chicken or lean meat at least thrice in a week. Other than protein, it contains fats, riboflavin, and calcium. Fourth group is fruits and vegetables. Various fruits like mangoes, orange, tomatoes, papaya, sweet lime, watermelon provides us with carotenoids, vitamin C, riboflavin, folic acid, iron, and fiber. Basically, fruits and vegetables will provide you micronutrients, that is vitamins and minerals. Then vegetables are subdivided into two groups, that is green leafy vegetables and other vegetables. Green leafy vegetables like amaranth, spinach, fenugreek, coriander contains riboflavin, folic acid, calcium, fiber, iron, and carotenoids. Other vegetables like carrots, onions, lady's finger, beans, cauliflower has again carotenoids, folic acid, and fiber in it. So try to include at least 4 to 5 servings of these vegetables in a day's diet. About selection of these vegetables, I will introduce a concept called a rainbow diet in our next slide. So the last food group is fats and sugar. Fats and sugars, fats like butter, oil, ghee, hydrogenated fats should be incorporated in limited amount, because it is considered as energy dense foods. 1 gram of fat will provide you 9 kilocalories of energy. That is almost more than double the energy you get from carbohydrates. So it is always advisable to reduce the or monitor the quantity of fats and sugars. Avoid fried foods too often, and the foods which contain hydrogenated fat or trans fats in it. But one should not skip fats totally from your diet, because it also contains essential fatty acids and some fat soluble vitamins like vitamin A, D, E, and K. If you stop consuming fats totally, then you will deprive yourself from getting all these essential fatty acids and fat soluble vitamins. I will explain you the role of some fat soluble vitamins in our next few slides. Also, sugar and jaggery should be consumed in limited amount as it provides only energy. Other micronutrients or fiber are not present in sugar and jaggery, so it is always advisable to consume it in moderation. Jaggery to some extent contain iron, but again, it should not be consumed too often in larger quantities. So I guess till now you are clear what are the food groups and which foods you should be including in your diet. So after including these foods, how the plate will look like? Okay, so let us check this. My plate will show you how your ideal plate should be. If you are eating in a plate which has a diameter of 9 inches, then fill the half portion of the plate with vegetables and fruits. Choose different vegetables and fruits from the discussed three groups. About their selection, again we will talk in rainbow diet. Then 1/4 of the portion should be filled with protein-rich foods. You can select various types of dals or legumes in the form of like usal we say, in that form, or any other preparation which is made from dals and legumes. You can add a cup of curd or other milk products like paneer or cheese in small amount, buttermilk. Then you can incorporate eggs. If you are non-vegetarian, choose fat-free chicken and lean meat in this particular 1/4 portion. Then last 1/4 portion should comprise of complex carbohydrates. How will you select these complex carbohydrates? From the first discussed group, that is cereals and grains group. You can add whole wheat chapati, multigrain roti or bajra roti, jawar roti, rice, whether it is brown rice or white rice, you can incorporate as per your liking, or pasta or noodles which are made up of wheat, and try to avoid pasta and noodles or bread which is made up of refined flour. Okay, so this will be your meal plate. Half of the plate should comprise of fruits and vegetables, 1/4 from protein sources, and 1/4 should be filled with complex carbohydrates. Generally, when we go out to buy vegetables, we purchase the vegetables as per the liking of our and our family members. But there are plenty of options available in the market. You have various different colored fruits and vegetables available with us. So try to select different different types of vegetables from different colors, because each particular color has health benefit of its own. So we will discuss the health benefit in short. Red color tomatoes or strawberries, watermelon, peppers reduces risk of cancers. Particularly cooked tomatoes are proven to be anti-cancerous, or they reduces the risk of developing prostate cancers in females. Then they are also considered as heart healthy and anti-inflammatory. White color foods like radish, onions, mushrooms, cauliflower, bananas improves our immunity. Onion and garlic is recommended for patients who have developed high cholesterol levels. Raw garlic, 4 to 5 cloves of raw garlic and half onion should be consumed daily, which will help in reduction of bad cholesterol. Again, if you consume this garlic in crushed form, then the benefits are, we will get more benefits out of it. Moving to yellow and orange colored fruits and vegetables, all yellow and orange colored fruits or vegetables have vitamin A in it. This is considered as antioxidants, and these fruits maintain our eye health. They also improve our immunity. So try to incorporate carrots, mangoes, oranges, yellow pepper, papaya in your daily diet. Much has been talked about greens. It is said that you should incorporate more of greens in your diet. It is because, again, it has cancer, anti-cancerous properties. It removes toxins from your body. And also, it has vitamin K in it. Vitamin, particularly green leafy vegetables. So, vitamin K is supposed to be, supposed to have a key role in blood thinning process. So, try to include all greens at least 5 times a week. And that too, green leafy vegetables at least 3 times a week. Then blue or purple color vegetables like eggplant, blueberries, cabbage, purple cabbage, raisins are also heart healthy and protective against cancer. So this was all about the selection of diet, which will help you maintain your ideal body weight and disease free, will keep you disease free for long. Again, the meal plate or the selection may vary depending on person's height, weight and medical condition, if any. As I said earlier, many of these foods improve your immunity. But other than diet, there are a few other factors also which affect our immunity adversely. So let us have a look on these factors. As I said earlier, diet has a direct role in improvisation of your immunity. So imbalance, if you are eating an imbalanced diet, you are restricting any particular food group for so long, it may develop some deficiencies of that particular nutrient and that may become your immune system. Similarly, excess consumption of sugar, junk, refined food, that is all the foods which is prepared out of maida. In the refining process, fiber and all the micronutrients, there is a loss of fiber and micronutrients. So it is better to restrict refined foods. Then soda and trans fat are also considered as immunity depressant. So try to avoid excess consumption of these foods. Then sedentary lifestyle and lack of health. It will increase your lack of sleep. It will increase your stress levels in the body. Also, sleep is necessary to rejuvenate yourself. So, if you are not allowing your body to take proper rest, if you are not keeping your body in action, in motion, or like any kind of activities, then again, there is a deposition of toxins in your body, which results in lower immunity. Emotional health has a major role in our health. As I said earlier, under stress levels, the immune systems work adversely. When you are under stress, there is a increased release of cortisol hormone, which suppresses your immunity. So try to incorporate some good exercise schedule in your lifestyle, take proper rest and adopt some stress relieving techniques. Use of medicine for long will also deposit some toxins in your body, and again it will depress or alter your immunity. When we talk about immunity, we cannot overlook our gut health. Gut health is nothing but our digestive tract, health of our digestive tract. Friends, around 70% of immunity lies in our gut. The absorption of nutrients, removal of toxins, or in short, the major portion of digestion happens in our gut. So it is utmost importance to keep our gut in healthy condition. There are few gut healthy foods which we should incorporate in our daily routine. High fiber food sources like vegetables and fruits, complex carbohydrates also contain some soluble fiber in it. So try to incorporate complex carbohydrates so that it will help your gut work smoothly. It will help you to remove toxins properly. So around 25 grams of fiber is required for adult. So you can add this fiber by incorporating complex carbohydrates and 4 to 5 servings of fruits and vegetables. Then foods like flax seeds, walnuts, fatty fish contains omega-3 fatty acids in it, which is again termed as gut healthy. Curds has lactobacillus bacteria in it, which are gut friendly. So try to incorporate 1 cup of curd in a day, or at least 2 to 3 glasses of buttermilk in a day. Fermented foods like idli, dosa, dhokla, they too are gut friendly. So try to incorporate these foods in your diet at least thrice a week. Also, the diet which is low in sugars will help you a lot in maintaining your gut strong and building up your immunity. Next factor which affects immunity adversely is inflammation. About half of the population is suffering from inflammation. So chronic inflammation may result in lowered immunity, fat deposition on abdomen, that is belly fat, joint pain, digestive issues, headache, heart diseases, skin issues, and so on. So it is increased stress levels may also increase inflammation. Sedentary lifestyle, lack of exercise will also lead to inflammation. So modify your life and try to incorporate, at the same time try to incorporate anti-inflammatory foods as well. The list of anti-inflammatory food includes green vegetables like spinach and broccoli. You can have unsalted nuts like almonds, cashews, pistachios, fresh berries like blueberries, raspberries, and strawberries. These berries and nuts can be consumed as a mid-meal snack, or you can make a smoothie out of these nuts and berries and curds and consume it as a pre-exercise meal. It will help you in reducing your inflammation, as well as it will improve your performance in exercises. Also, tomatoes are again considered as anti-inflammatory foods. Then, if you want to reduce your inflammation and bacterial inflammation, if any, then try to have turmeric with black pepper. It is necessary to add a dash of black pepper whenever you consume turmeric as a medicine or herb, because black pepper enhances the power of turmeric and you get the full benefit of turmeric. So you can have a turmeric milk or latte in a day. Then, like anti-inflammatory foods and gut healthy foods, there are some foods and nutrients which help in building our immunity. The main nutrient is again protein, as it is required in the growth process in kids, and it helps in healing and recovery process of the body. There is continuous wear and tear is happening in our body. So to happen it smoothly, you need to incorporate protein in your diet. Your breakfast, your lunch, and dinner should contain one source of protein in it. These are the three main meals of the day. So try to add at least one source of protein in these meals. Other milk protein sources are lean meat, poultry, eggs, beans, dals and legumes, soy products, unsalted nuts, and seeds. Vitamin C, it supports the immune system by stimulating the formation of antibodies. At the same time, vitamin helps in the absorption of iron. So make sure you are having plenty of vitamin C in your daily diet. The sources of vitamin C are citrus fruits like lemons, oranges, and sweet limes. You can have amla. It is a great source of vitamin C. Whenever fresh amlas are available, consume it raw or boil it and have it. Or if during off season, you can have preserved amla as well. Again, tomatoes and red peppers and guavas do contain good amount of vitamin C. Zinc is the other micronutrient which is considered as immunity booster. Though zinc is required in very small amount, you should not or you cannot neglect it. Try to fulfill your daily zinc requirements through lean meat, poultry, seafood, milk, whole grain products, beans, seeds, and nuts. Then recent research has shown that the person with low levels of vitamin D are more prone to catch infections than the person whose vitamin D levels are within the range. So try to improve your vitamin D levels if they are on lower side. You can improve your vitamin D levels by eating whole eggs, salmon, tuna, milk, or exposing yourself to early sunlight. If at all the deficiency is severe, then you can take a help of vitamin D supplementation, and that too with the help with the consultation of any doctor and or a nutritionist. Vitamin A and vitamin E are again considered or termed as immunity boosters. Basically, they work as an antioxidant. They fight with the free radicals which are developed or built in our body, and hence they help us keeping ourselves in healthy conditions. The sources of vitamin A are sweet potatoes, carrots, spinach, red bell peppers, apricots, and eggs. You will get your vitamin E from sunflower seeds, almonds, vegetable oils such as sunflower or safflower oil. Basically, all oil seeds contain vitamin E. So you can consume these seeds along with nuts as a midmeal snack, or you can sprinkle them over a salad and you can consume it. Then omega-3 fatty acids from fatty fish, flax seeds, walnuts also plays a key role in improving your immunity. So try to incorporate these foods as well. Fish intake at least twice or thrice a week is recommended in healthy conditions. Spices like ginger, turmeric, and garlic are again considered as superfoods because they have anti-inflammatory properties as well as if they are immunity boosters as well. Ginger helps our body warm, and it is again considered as it has antibacterial properties. It soothes our throat if you have any throat infection. So you can add ginger in your regular chai or in lemon water or in spices or in the gravies. Also, you can add it in turmeric milk to enhance the taste of turmeric milk. About turmeric, we have discussed it in previous slide, as it has anti-inflammatory properties, it has antibacterial properties. So try to have a cup of turmeric milk in this adverse situation, along with black pepper. About garlic also, it lowers your cholesterol levels as well as it improves your immunity also. So try to incorporate garlic in your daily diet. Now, during these 2 to 3 months, the clients who have approached me for diet consultation have discussed their few challenges with me. And these challenges, I have tried to tabulate them, and we will discuss it in these coming 2 to 3 slides. So first challenge is overeating. This may be because of work from home condition. When you are working at home, there is an easy access to the food. Also, there is emotional eating was also observed because there is a lot of stress around. Daily, there is rise in COVID-19 cases. That is very disturbing. Then your work pressure, you have to complete your professional task in a given time. Domestic help is not available in many areas. So there is an additional burden of household chores. So in that case, we tend to eat whatever is easily available or whatever we can cook easily. So in that case, usually there are wrong food choices. So that leads to weight gain or increased fat percentage. And if it continues for long, then there is increased risk of health disorders associated with weight gain and digestive problems as well. Then there are a few ways to overcome this challenge. First of all, maintain your meal timings. Never skip your breakfast. Breakfast should be proper. It should be the main meal of the day. You can have a combination of proteins and cereals in your breakfast. I will explain it with few examples. Like if you are having poha or upma, you can add few peanuts or sprouted legumes to it. Then you can have parathas with curds. You can have idli, dosa or dhokla with mint chutney. Other, if you are eating eggs, and you can choose boiled eggs or omelette with chapati or whole wheat bread. So this will be a sumptuous breakfast and it will be a great start for the day. Then if at all if you feel hungry in between two meals, then munch on some healthy snacks like nuts, salads, fruits, sprouts, curds, etc. If at all you feel like eating some sweets, then you can have a small piece of dark chocolate or raisins, few raisins, you can say 4 to 5 raisins, or a fruit. Then important thing is about hydration. Hydrate yourself well. At least 2.5 to 3 liters of water intake is recommended. Another challenge faced by the people is of weight gain. Weight gain is due to overeating, wrong food choices, as I said earlier, due to increased pressure or availability of foods. Many our dietary habits are changed a lot. You are eating whatever is available and whatever is easy to cook. So that may lead to weight gain. Again, lack of exercise, gyms are closed. So the people who prefer their workout in gyms, they may experience experience muscle loss due to their stopped workout strength training. Then again, it may lead to altered immunity. How to overcome weight gain issue? So the main thing is control your portions. Discuss with your nutritionist and decide the portions as per your activity levels and stick to it. Eat fresh foods every day. Avoid processed and ready-to-cook foods. Avoid junk, sweets or excess amount of salt. And again, exercise daily. Many patients or clients, we can say, reported constipation nowadays. This is because of wrong food choices. Again, they are eating processed food. There is decreased fluid intake and lack of exercise. Constipation, if not treated on time, it may lead to acne, or chronic constipation may lead to hemorrhoids or anal fissures. To overcome constipation, you need to increase fiber content from the diet. As I said earlier, try to incorporate 4 to 5 servings of fruits and vegetables in the daily diet. You can add vegetables to your breakfast items like poha, upma, along with sprouts and peanuts. You can have vegetable soups or complex carbohydrates like whole wheat. You can add a few chopped coriander leaves, or you can make methi parathas or palak parathas. In that way, try to increase your fiber content or vegetable contents. Then avoid refined foods. All types of refined foods, that is the foods which are prepared from maida, should be avoided. Improve fluid intake. Again, 2.5 to 3 liters of fluids. It may be in the form of plain water, or vegetable soups, or vegetable smoothies, buttermilk, and so on. And exercise is must. Then lockdown, we all are at home. So there is a high possibility that we are not exposing ourselves to early morning sunlight for a longer period. So lack of sunlight and dietary deficiencies is developing into vitamin C D deficiency. So vitamin, if you are vitamin D deficient, then there are high chances of catching frequent infections. You may experience fatigue or pain in bones and muscles and hair loss. If vitamin D deficiency is not corrected at proper time, then there are cases of depression and heart disease developed due to deficiency of vitamin D. So add eggs, salmon, tuna and milk to the diet and expose yourself to morning sunlight. You can exercise or go for at least a brisk walk is also sufficient to get that sunlight. Then many ladies are worried about hair fall. It is again due to wrong food choices, lack of care or stress. Our hair and nails are made up of proteins. So they need proteins to remain in healthy condition. So increase proteins from your diet. Again, I will repeat, incorporate pulses, dals, legumes, eggs, milk and milk products and non-vegetarian foods in your daily diet. Include flax seeds, walnuts and almonds as well. Also take good care of your hair. Then there is a lot of change in our daily schedule. So that addition to that, there is stress. So that may lead to sleep disorders. And if you have sleep disorder for long, disturbed sleep for long, then there may arise issues related to weight loss or digestion related issues. So to overcome these sleeping disorder, avoid heavy meals, particularly heavy dinners. Limit your screen time. Try to de-stress yourself by involving in any kind of meditation or yoga or any stress relieving activity, like developing some kind of hobby or so. And if at all your sleep is disturbed for longer period, then you can have warm milk with turmeric and black pepper before your bedtime. So if you observe all these challenges and ways to overcome these challenges, the common thing is lifestyle. If you disturb your lifestyle, if it is not as per the, what we can say, it is not proper, the timings are varying day from day to day, like one day you are eating your lunch at one, next day you are skipping your lunch or having it at 2 or 3 o'clock. If you are not following any exercise schedule regularly, if your sleep is disturbed, then there are high chances of developing some disorders and which are related to your immune system or metabolism. So try to modify your life, set a proper routine and lead a healthy life. Now there are some diet tips which are designed for students. So first of all, the most important tip is do not miss your breakfast or any other meal. As I said earlier, breakfast is the main meal. Breakfast should be the main meal. So have poha, upma, idli, dosa, parathas, omelette, boiled sprouts as your breakfast. It should be heavy and at the earliest. Don't prolong it after getting up. Like you are getting up at 6 and having breakfast at 9. No. So take it as early as possible. Then eat plenty of fruits and vegetables. Refer rainbow diet in selection of fruits and vegetables. Then students, particularly when they are chatting with their friends or they are spending some time on social media or on television, they tend to eat something. And usually the temptation is like to eat wafers or fries or all cheesy items or maybe the foods which are high in calories. So my advice is to swap these snacks such as wafers, fries, cakes, instant noodles with nuts and seeds, vegetables, fruits. You can prepare some healthy dips and have enjoy your vegetables and fruits with it. You can have salad with hummus or curd dip instead of mayonnaise. Then add egg whites to your diet, unbuttered popcorn, kurkura dry bean, roasted makhana or soyabean. These are all healthy snack options. Again, reduce your junk food is not only high in calories, but it has lots of fats and sodium. Mostly it is saturated or trans fats in the junk, present in junk food. So when you go out for, this is not possible in this situation, but it will help you in maybe after 2 to 3 months. So when you go out with your friends, while selecting a menu, try to avoid the crunchy, crispy, creamy, cheesy foods. Instead, choose baked, steamed, grilled or roasted foods. If at all these foods are not available, like baked, steamed, grilled, roasted foods are not available, then control your portions. Serve yourself like a kid. Small portion of these foods along with some vegetables if available or salad if available. Then hydrate well with plain water, herbal or green tea, buttermilk, coconut water, lemon water. Other good hydration options are vegetable soups, vegetable smoothies and so on. At the same time, avoid or limit alcohol intake, aerated drinks and sweetened beverages. Sweetened beverages will add up additional sugar or calories in your body. Aerated drinks has soda in it. So soda bicarbonate extracts calcium from your bones and thus weakening your bones. Adverse effects of alcohol are well known, so try to avoid it. Also, students are awake till wee hours due to many reasons. They have their submissions to complete, or they may spend time on social media or watching web series and so on. So there is again a chances like you get tempted to eat those high calorie snacks. Many of the students, of the college going students, end up eating instant noodles or wafers or biscuits in the night. So try to restrict these kind of snacks and avoid or include a fruit or again nuts if you cannot control your cravings for midnight munching. Then remember not to follow any fad or crash diet. Various types of diets are available on internet nowadays, or many friends or our relatives suggest us any kind of diet. But before selecting any type of diet, you should ask few questions to yourself, like for how many days I can follow this type of diet. Next question should be, is there any health disadvantage or any adverse effect by this diet on my body, and the results, whether the results of this diet are long lasting or not. If you get satisfactory answers for all these questions, then go ahead and follow that diet. But it is always advisable to modify your lifestyle, eat a balanced diet with portion control, get a customized diet planned with the help of a nutritionist, and achieve your target. There is a rise in eating disorders in these nowadays. So if at all you find if you are having some kind of eating disorder, then get help from medical. Exercise will not only helpful for weight loss, but it also tones your body. It increases your muscle strength, which is healthy in many aspects. In girls, the cases of hormonal imbalances are on rise. So it is important for girls to incorporate some weight training in their daily diet. Also, it releases good hormones, which help you de-stress. So again, get a customized exercise schedule done for you. It should be as per your stamina and strength level, stamina levels and strength. A combination of good cardio exercises, that is jogging, running, cycling, skipping, or some weight training. Weight training can be done at home as well, and incorporation of some yoga or breathing exercises will help you a lot. It will not help keep you in a healthy condition physically, but it will also help you relax mentally, and it will help you in your studies as well. Again, sleep well, do not disturb your biological clock, follow a routine, follow your bedtime, follow your waking up time, follow your exercise schedule and time, and again follow a balanced diet and meal timings. So that is all about a healthy diet and few tips for the students. Thank you for listening it quietly.
Thank you, ma'am, for your valuable insights. I now request Sandhya ma'am to kindly highlight the key points of the session.
Thank you, Nabha. Firstly, I would like to say that it was a very informative session. Thank you, ma'am, for sharing your valuable knowledge and experience with us. Ma'am has introduced us to amazing concepts of different food groups for a balanced diet and the rainbow diet concept for selection of vegetables, which will make our meal plate colorful and full of nutrients. In the current COVID-19 situation, the immunity boosting foods and nutrients suggested by ma'am are very important, and we will surely try to include them in our diet. Also, the diet tips given for our students are very helpful, and I'm sure they'll try to follow them. Thank you, ma'am, and we are grateful for the time and effort you took to be here with us today. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I would now like to hand over to Kea for the question answer round.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, we have a few questions for you over here. The first question to you is, what would be, during these COVID times, what would be the difference between consuming vitamin C from natural sources and supplements that the doctors recommend? And also, in addition to it, we are prescribed certain Ayurvedic medicines and kadas. How do they supplement our health with that?
Okay. So, as I said earlier, it is always better to fulfill your nutrient requirements through the diet. But in such adverse condition, many places there is the foods which are good in vitamin C, like citrus fruits and lemons, are not available due to some lockdown conditions. And the need for these vitamins is on rise. So in that case, if you are at high risk of developing these kind of infections and the food sources are not available, then definitely you can have a supplement, because it is a concentrated source of vitamin C. As far as the Ayurvedic kadhas are concerned, the kadha which is recommended by the government has most of the herbs and spices in it. So if at all you can incorporate all the spices or herbs in your daily diet, you can consume it with food. Or else, again, if you are at a high risk category or the cases around you are high, then it is always recommended to consume this kadha. It definitely has good benefit on our body.
Ma'am, we have the next question from Samruddhi Sharma. She is asking that as architecture students, due to prolonged screen times, we are unable to follow our dietary needs. So any suggestions to help us better our health?
See, if you follow a particular routine, like where we follow our college timetable, accordingly try to incorporate or try to maintain that food timing. It will not take much to have a lunch or a dinner, because in a long it will affect your body adversely. So if you are talking about screen time and the increased stress on your eyesight, increased stress on your eyesight, then try to incorporate vitamin A rich foods, but don't skip any meals. It should not be any excuse for anybody, I can say, try to incorporate all the foods, and you can, you know, combine it in single dish also. It is not necessary, like as it was shown in the plate, there was separate vegetables and protein sources and carbohydrates. So you can make a single dish, which can be easily consumed. That way, try to modify your diet, but don't skip it. You can have wraps which has vegetables and paneer or sprouts in it, so that you will get all the food groups. Or sandwiches you can have, or vegetable parathas with stuffed chia paneer, you can have that. So it will take less time to consume it.
Ma'am, with respect to nutrients, what would be the difference between home-cooked meals and meal provided by certain brands that are developed by dietitians and they provide keto and vegan diets? Also, in addition to this, I would like to add Shraddha Sardesai ma'am's question, which she's asking about your opinion on diets of Madhuri Dixit Devkar and in relation with the vegan diets.
Okay, so home-cooked food should always be preferred, but due to some reasons, if it is not possible and the source from which you are taking the food is trusted, then you can go ahead with the food that is recommended by your dietitian. But before consuming that food, try to understand the timing of consumption of that food, at what time you need to consume that food, what all ingredients are present in that particular food, what is the nutritive value of that food, and also the serving size of that food. If you are clear about these ideas, then you can choose a diet or food which is prescribed by your dietitian. But home cooked food will always be a first option. Secondly, in vegan diet particularly, you restrict all the milk and milk products also. So there are high chances of developing some calcium deficiency, as it is a good source of calcium and proteins also. So it is recommended not to follow any kind of fat diet which restrict yourself from getting some kind of or some type of nutrients. It's of no use if you are restricting it from natural sources and then consuming pills of it. So better not to follow any diet, fat diet, which restrict you from any particular food group. If you have some deficiency issues like lactose intolerance and all, then that may be another case. But in normal healthy condition, try to get your need, fulfill your needs from natural sources also.
Now, next we have two questions which are quite similar. We have a question from Mohit Srivastav. He's asking whether the body fat composition keeps changing. And the next question is from Jayashree Bhosle, ma'am. She's asking how to control increasing weight and maintain energy at the same time.
Okay, so yes, body composition keeps on changing. It is totally, body composition is a result of your eating habits and your exercise schedule. If you are doing proper customized diet and exercise schedule, then only it will be in your target range. But if you stop exercising, if you stop consuming healthy diet, then definitely it will keep changing. And second thing is keeping your energy levels high and at the same time remaining, what was the question? Keeping your weight in control. Okay, so it is not like that if you want to lose weight, you should restrict yourself to very small amount of foods. You can modify your diet with you can swap simple sugars with carbohydrates. Okay, so that you will get a steady supply of glucose throughout the day. If you consume a teaspoon of sugar, then there will be a spike in energy levels after a few minutes or say half an hour. Then along with that, if you don't consume anything, then your energy levels will be down after few after an hour or so. But if you replace these foods with complex carbohydrates and proteins, then there will be a constant supply of energy throughout the day, and your energy levels will be maintained. At the same time, have small and frequent meals. That also helps in maintaining your energy levels, as well as small and short meals along with proper exercises increases our metabolic rate, and that helps in weight loss. So you will achieve your target weight with small and frequent meals, as well as you will keep your energy levels same throughout the day. I hope it is clear.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, Jayashree Bhosle ma'am is also asking how to increase and maintain energy with the advancing age, as in increasing age, how can you maintain energy?
Okay, again, to increase energy levels, you should not skip your breakfast, because at the early morning, if you fuel your body, then it will work good throughout the day. And again, exercises as per your age and your stamina and strength will keep you energized. Third important thing, we get energy from our breathing technique also. I am not expert in breathing technique, but I myself have experienced that, so I would like to share. If you follow certain meditation or breathing techniques, definitely you will see a change in your energy levels. At the same time, a good sound sleep of 7 hours, if you are getting that much of sleep, then also you will find a definite drastic change in your energy levels. It will be a positive one.
Ma'am, the next question is by Indumani ma'am. Over here, she is asking, what is a balanced diet? How does it differ from person to person, and what would be the best electrolytes to consume as a supplement?
Okay, so as I discussed in my second or third slide, balanced diet is a diet which includes all the food groups. We have discussed these food groups. In short, the diet which contains cereals and pulses, milk and milk products, non-vegetarian foods if you eat non-vegetarian, leafy vegetables, other vegetables, and fruits. Okay, that is considered as balanced diet. But it should be in as per your requirement, body's requirement, as per your height, age, and your weight. It is a calculation, so it differs from person to person, again depending on the medical condition and the exercise or activity levels. The need of each nutrient varies from person to person. For example, if X person requires 2000 kilocalories, and protein content should always be 0.8 grams per kg of your body weight. Like if you are weighing 50 kgs, then you should consume at least 0.8 to 1 grams of protein a day. That is near to 50 grams of protein. Then 4 to 5 servings of vegetables. That all will comprise a balanced diet.
Ma'am, the next question we have is from Rupal Vyasma. She is asking that it is said that leafy vegetables are not preferable during monsoons. So is that true? And a similar question is that in the current situation of COVID, how are we supposed to wash the produce that we get?
So vegetables are generally grown to the ground level. So during monsoons particularly, there is a rise or growth of bacteria and other microorganisms is on higher side. So there are high chances that these vegetables get infected with these microorganisms. So try to reduce the amount of leafy vegetables during monsoons. Or if whenever you consume it, wash it with salt and turmeric water, and then you can have it. And during this time also, when you buy some vegetables from market, wash it with salt and turmeric water, keep it aside for few hours, and then again before cooking, you wash it and then consume it.
Ma'am, Jayashree Bhosle ma'am also adds to the question that does mental stress increase weight?
Yes, definitely. It increases your weight because mental, as I said earlier, it releases a cortisol hormone. Okay, that may, lead to cravings for sweets or any junk food. And also metabolic rate also gets affected with high levels of stress. And that may reduce the rate of weight loss, or you can put on your weight.
Ma'am, another question we have is, are there any foods that refresh the mind and instantly increase the productivity of the person?
Sorry, can you repeat?
Ma'am, any foods that refresh the mind instantly and increase the productivity of the person?
Yes, there are few foods which increase your increase the productivity. You can say dark chocolates or oats, spinach and berries. They are stress, they have properties in them that help us release our stress. So if you consume these foods, then definitely you will feel fresh and your productivity will increase. Few people tend to eat sweets when to get energized quickly. But it is a wrong practice. If at all you feel to have a sweet at that particular try time, resist yourself. Instead of simple sugars, have berries or nuts or fresh fruit. That will help you a lot.
Ma'am, one more question from Maryam, ma'am, is during prolonged screen hours during the COVID lockdown, how should we take care of our eyes and what foods can help?
Okay, as far as food part is concerned, we add all orange and yellow colored vegetables and fruits to your diet, like carrots, pumpkin, or papaya and yellow peppers. Then you can take care of your health eyes by थोड़ा सा थोड़े टाइम के लिए ऑफ स्क्रीन हो जाइए और थोड़ा आगे दूर का देखिए. लाइक यू आर योर विजन इज लाइक नियर, बहुत स्क्रीन के पास आप बैठते हैं तो थोड़ा दूर का अगर देखते हैं तो वो भी मसल को उसका इफेक्ट हो जाता है एंड रिलैक्सेशन हो जाता है.
Ma'am, over here, the last question. Since most of the students like us, we stay in hostels and away from home. So, and the food that is provided by the mess is particularly oily. So any snack recommendation or food that can be cooked easily?
Okay, you can boil eggs. If sprouts are available nearby, you can get soaked sprouts with vegetable in the vegetable market as well. So you can boil them and have as a snack. You can have fruits. If blender is available, make a smoothie out of fruits and nuts. Or if you really can cook, then you can have khichdi, like wholesome fruit, or oats, muesli are there. Then there is rajgira chikki, rajgira laddu, which are very good in your, as far as nutritional value is concerned. And again, dry fruits and nuts. These are all healthy options.
Thank you, ma'am, for answering all our questions. And as students, we'll surely try to incorporate all your tips. I would now like to invite Yugantara, ma'am, to give the vote of thanks.
Thank you, Kia. Thank you so much, Dr. Priyanka, ma'am, for this very informative session. It was truly very valuable piece of advice for our students. During this lockdown period, I'm very sure many of us have changed their eating habits. After today's session, we will definitely improve upon eating habits as well. On behalf of Pillai HSC College of Architecture, students and faculties, I would like to thank you again, ma'am. I would take this opportunity to thank our Honorable Chairman, Dr. Vasudevan Pillai, sir, Daphne, ma'am, CEO Lata Menon, ma'am, for giving us such a platform to conduct a webinar for our students. I also want to thank our motivator, Principal Suchita Sayaji, ma'am. She always encourages us to do new things related to our field and beyond that, which benefit our students and their families. Last but not the least, I would also thank my colleague Sandhya Mhatre, ma'am, and students of a fifth year batch who played important role in organizing this webinar. That's all, everyone. Thank you for being part of this webinar. Now we can log out this session. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I am also glad to connect with you all.